Hi friends, welcome to CrackU. In today's session, we will be looking at some important points regarding small finance bank and payments bank. The concept of small finance bank and payments bank was introduced by RBI in the year 2014 based on the recommendation of Nachiket Mor committee. Small finance bank and payments, the guidelines for small finance bank and payments bank were introduced in the year 2014. Let us first look at, in brief, what is a small finance bank or why a small finance bank. Before small finance bank or payments bank, we used to have universal banks, or they are called scheduled commercial banks. But based on the recommendations of Nachiket Mor committee, based on the recommendation of this committee, a type of banks called differentiated bank were planned to be introduced. For the reason, to serve a specific segment of the society. Like if you look at the small finance bank is primarily aimed at serving the unserved and underserved. And moreover, to enhance the financial inclusion and supply credit to micro and small enterprises, and along with agriculture, and providing basic banking facilities in unbanked regions of the country. So there is a specific segment on which small finance bank or payments banks are targeted. For this reason, the concept of small finance bank and payments bank were introduced by RBI in 2014, and the specific guidelines were given during the same time. Let us look at what are the different small finance banks in India as in September this year. There are in total 11 small finance banks. As you can see, these are some of them. There can be in every bank exam, you see one or two questions on the guidelines of small finance bank or payments bank, or on the like head or CEO or headquarters of small finance bank. So these are some of the important small finance bank. Jana Small Finance Bank, which started operations recently in 2018. CEO is Ajay Kanwal and it is headquartered at Bangalore. And there is another two, three important banks on which repeated questions are asked in almost all bank exams, like Fincare Small Finance Bank, Equitas Small Finance Bank. So there are 11 small finance banks at present, and these are various heads and the headquarters of small finance banks here. So three small finance banks, Jana Small, Ujjivan Small and Fincare Small Finance Bank, are headquartered in Bangalore. ESOF and Equitas in Chennai. Capital Small Finance Bank, which is the first small finance bank which started operations in 2016, is headquartered in Jalandhar, and the head of Capital Small Finance Bank is Sarvajit Singh Sharma. And AU Small Finance Bank is located in Jaipur, Utkarsh Small Finance Bank in Varanasi, and Suryoday Small Finance Bank in Mumbai. So majority of the headquarters of small finance banks are in Bangalore. What is a payment bank? A payment bank is similar to a small finance bank. It is different in its operations and guidelines. It is also a differentiated bank. Actually, targeted for like low income households and small business in the country. But as such, payments bank, like as you all know, Paytm Payments Bank or the recently launched India Post Payments Bank, they are targeted at the common individual. So these are special or differentiated banks. These are also aimed at improving the financial inclusion in the country by providing small savings accounts and some other payments and remittance services to the target sector, that is income households, like small business in the country, and something like that. Let us look at some of total number of payment banks in India. There are at present 6 payment banks. India Post Payment Bank is the latest entrant. It was launched on September 1st by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And another recent bank which started operation was Jio Payments Bank. This is Reliance. Jio Payments Bank is a joint venture between Reliance Industries and State Bank of India. And the CEO of Jio Payments Bank is H.R. Krishnan, and it is headquartered in Mumbai. India Post Payments Bank, it is a wholly owned government by India. 100% it is owned by government of India. And the CEO of India Post Payment Bank is Suresh Sethi, and it is headquartered in New Delhi. And as you all know, Paytm Payments Bank, which was also launched in 2017. Right now, CEO post is vacant. Renu Sethi was the previous CEO. The chairman is Vijay Shekhar Sharma, the founder. And it is headquartered in Noida. Airtel Payments Bank, which was recently restricted from accepting new deposits for violation of various norms pertaining to acceptance of savings, acceptance of more balances in savings account. So it is restricted for some time from accepting deposits. And the CEO is Anubrata Biswas, and it is headquartered in New Delhi. Even Fino Payments Bank is also under restriction for some time. Let us look at some of the important guidelines issued by RBI for Small Finance Bank and Payments Bank. These will be important from the exam point of view. First one, capital requirement. For a small finance bank, for anyone to start a small finance bank, the minimum capital requirement is 100 crore, which is also same for Payments Bank. License, small finance bank and payment banks are licensed under Section 22 of Banking Regulation Act 1949. So both are licensed under the same section. The primary activity for small finance bank is accepting deposits as well as lending, but for payments bank it is only accepting demand deposits and no term deposits, and even it is also restricted from lending. So it can only accept deposits, and we'll see further how much amount, what is the maximum cap on acceptance of deposits. And the minimum capital adequacy ratio is 15% of the total risk weighted assets of the bank, which is also same for small payments bank. So when it comes to promoter contribution, this question is regularly asked in bank exams. Minimum initial contribution of paid up capital of the small finance bank, the promoter should hold at least 40%. Or minimum 40% he has to hold initially in the small finance bank, which has to be brought down at least for the first 5 years, which has to be brought down to 30% after 10 years, and it has to be further brought down to 26% after 12 years. And this is from the date of commencement of business. And if a small finance bank reaches its net worth reaches rupees 500 crore, it has to be listed on the stock exchange within 3 years from achieving this 500 crore net worth, and that is mandatory. But if it has not reached this 500 crore mark, it need not be listed on the stock exchange. And for promoter's contribution in case of payments bank, the minimum initial contribution should be 40%, and there is no restriction like it has to be brought down to 30% or 26% after 10 years or 12 years. Priority sector lending norms. For small finance bank, as it is also into lending along with accepting deposits, 75% of adjusted net bank credit has to be to the eligible sectors for under priority sector lending norms. Whereas payments bank, as it only can accept demand deposit but it cannot lend, so there is no restriction as such of priority sector lending norms in case of payments bank. Let us look at some more important points regarding small finance bank and payments bank. So when it comes to loans and advances, as we have seen, as payments bank cannot give any loans, there is no specific restriction on it. But when you talk about small finance bank, at least 50% of the loan portfolio should be up to 25 lakhs. This is one of the important restriction on small finance bank, which is regularly asked in exams. And if talking about opening of branches as applicable to scheduled banks, scheduled commercial banks, At least 25% of the branches should be in unbanked and rural areas. One more important point is like banking correspondents, SFB, small finance bank, cannot become a banking correspondent or a correspondent for another bank, but payments bank can become a banking correspondent for other banks. So for this reason, payments bank need not have to open the 25% bank branches in unbanked or rural areas. They can operate through banking as a banking correspondent or through ATMs, or they can just install ATM, but they need not mandatorily open branches, 25% stipulation of branches in rural or unbanked areas. So coming to maximum balance that can be held in the savings account, there is no such restriction on in small finance bank for the balances held in small finance bank, but rupees 1 lakh is the maximum amount that can be held by an individual in a payments bank. So this is one important point to note, one major differentiation between small finance bank and payments bank. And as we have already discussed, a small finance bank cannot become a banking correspondent for another bank, whereas payments bank can become a banking correspondent for some other bank. So when it talk about foreign shareholding, it is common for both, which is as per the priority sector norms prescribed by Reserve Bank of India. Any foreign entity can hold up to a maximum of 74% of the paid up capital in a small finance bank, and it is also same for payments bank. Apart from this, payments bank has to maintain, apart from CRR, cash reserve ratio, it has to maintain, it also has to maintain 75% of demand deposits in terms of government securities or treasury bills with maturity up to 1 year, and a maximum of 25% as current and fixed deposits with scheduled commercial banks, which is not applicable or which is not a mandatory restriction in case of a small finance bank. Let us look at some other important points on current affairs regarding the small finance bank and payments bank. Payments bank cannot also issue credit cards, and small finance bank and payments bank, from 2018 January, they are allowed to issue Atal Pension Yojana, which earlier they were not allowed to issue. Atal Pension Yojana, which is a social sector scheme introduced by Government of India. The third important current affair, which is a recent current affair, as we have discussed earlier, it is India Post Payments Bank, IPPB, which is launched by Government of India, which was launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on September 1st, 2018. It is 100% owned by Government of India, and the outlay for India Post Payments Bank, which was earlier 800 crore, has been enhanced to rupees 1435 crore recently for improving its operations. So this is all about small finance bank and payments bank. In the description of this video, you can find links to study material of various exams prepared by CrackU. Kindly subscribe for more videos. If you have any doubts, please comment in the comment section below. Thank you.